have a story of my own. My story is Christine's story, and many like her. I'm lucky enough to represent Christine and about 1,000 other Americans, all people that came down with non-Hodgkin lymphoma after significant exposure to Roundup and other Monsanto glyphosate products. Christine was my first client in this. She was the first lost to leaf out, and I'm very hopeful that she may be the first to go to trial in America and have a jury of her peers decide what to do about this. Non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, of course, is an insidious disease. It's a cancer of the lymph system. It can form very quickly as opposed to other solid organ cancers. And there are many, many subtypes. We all know, the scientific community knows, that glyphosate can cause non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. There's certainly a strong suggestion that it can cause multiple myeloma or lymph cancer as well. The epidemiology on the subject says that as little as 2 days a year of exposure to glyphosate or 10 cumulative lifetime days is enough to double or triple the risk of getting lymphoma. As I said, we represent about 1,000 people. About half of them are farmers who routinely use Monsanto products on their row crops in America. We represent several hundred landscapers, people that work on others' lawns and plant turf and ornamental bushes and use Roundup products in their daily jobs as well. And we represent a handful of homeowners, just people that have seen the advertisements for this product, bought the spray bottles themselves in the hardware store, and used it repeatedly on their own fence line or their own home garden, and all of them contracted them from significant use of the product. As we know, while glyphosate is intended to be directly toxic to plants, Monsanto would like to have us believe it's non-toxic to humans, and in fact, they've marketed in America as practically non-toxic. That's the phrase they use. They've told us in America that it is safe as table salt. And they have been sanctioned in one state, New York, for advertising along those lines and made to retract some of those statements. But to date, here in 2016, there has never been a warning on any of these products. There's never been a caveat added to any of the advertisements to explain that there's a risk, a grave risk of non-Hodgkin lymphoma from using the product. There are no precautions recommended by Monsanto for using this product, whether you're spraying it from a backpack broadcaster, spraying it from a plane, or you're down on your knees in the garden. They don't recommend any precautions against to protect yourself from cancer. And of course, their position is glyphosate is not a carcinogen. The wonderful thing about the civil tort system in America is, as we also know, Monsanto has infiltrated government all over the world. They have infiltrated very deeply into the executive branch in America. We have the Environmental Protection Agency, which is charged with regulating these products and registering them, and they are going through a re-registration process right now. I don't have a tremendous amount of hope in that regulatory process. There are many Monsanto executives that now work in EPA. There are many former EPA regulators that now work at Monsanto or do consultation for them. However, we get to bypass all that in the jury system. And what we will do is take somewhere between 7 and 12 ordinary Americans, peers of Ms. Shepherd, or other people all over the country, put them in a box and tell our story. Monsanto says it doesn't cause cancer. They've got a handful of studies, which of course they funded or goes through, that says that there's no association found. The combination of the studies, of course, finds a very strong association. And we get to go into court and tell our story and tell Christine's story, tell that side of the science, and this panel of ordinary Americans will get to decide who they think the inventor is right and what to do about it. So we're speaking the language that Monsanto understands, and I truly would say the only language Monsanto and other multinational corporations understand is the bottom line and profit. And so we'll be asking jurors across America to consider these issues and to take what they think is fair for Monsanto to give it to Christine to compensate her for her illness and many, many others like her. At the moment, just last week, these cases in America were consolidated in what's called a multi-district litigation in San Francisco and Northern California. There's a judge there who's going to be hearing all of these cases in advance of trial and may be sent across the country again for the individual trials. We're pleased with that development. And I would expect there are about 50 cases in the court system right now, and I would expect by this time next year there may be as many as 5,000. We're certainly well aware of at least 70 people that are linking their disease to glyphosate use. There's some evidence that speaking this language to Monsanto is effective. And again, while they can infiltrate government and they can infiltrate Congress, there's not much that they can do to an American jury. There have been trials in the last few years against Monsanto regarding the PCBs that they produced until the 70s. And there have been some good favorable verdicts for people hurt by those chemicals. Recently, you may have heard that Monsanto set aside, I believe, $250 million in the last week or two to pay those claims. Now, I don't think that was out of the goodness of their heart, but that's going to hurt them a little bit. And that's how we intended to change Monsanto and try to change the world, is to continue to do that work. And I'm very lucky to be able to do so and my time.
Thank you very much. Good to see you now, but the young, beautiful.
Pregunto en español. Muchas gracias por sus testimonios. Yo tengo dos preguntas. La primera es la información médica, de quienes han tratado tanto a la señora Cristina como a otras personas que conocen, va en el sentido de que los males, las enfermedades derivan del producto. Esa es una parte. Y la otra parte, la comercialización del producto, la compra del producto, ¿es la hace directamente con Monsanto? ¿Hay alguna empresa intermediaria? Y en ese caso, la responsabilidad legal, también en este caso en los Estados Unidos, ¿caería sobre la empresa comercializadora, directamente sobre Monsanto o sobre las dos? Y si considera que el marco legal sería suficiente para posibilidades de reparación del daño.
Did you understand the question?
No.
Very fit and very healthy, and in my early 50s, why would I get
lymphoma. Nobody could give me the answer. And it wasn't until the World Health Organization published their findings about the links between lymphoma and Roundup that I knew what had happened to me. When you have non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, every time it's in the news, those words leap out of the page and you read to see what's going on. And California was attempting to follow the World Health Organization guidelines, and I read that Monsanto was suing California so that they wouldn't have to label the product as carcinogenous. And along with that came a list of lawyers who were looking for people to tell their cases if they felt that they had been affected. And that's when I contacted the legal firm to see what could be done. Before that, there was no proof that I knew of, nothing to tell me that Roundup caused my lymphoma.
That's okay. Just in 5 minutes.
We haven't made any specific allegations against intermediaries, really. I think that a lot of them are as much in the dark as we are, as our physicians. Until the last couple of years, anybody could go to the oncologist and say, do you have an idea what caused my lymphoma? And they may say chemicals, they may say pesticides. Very few of them have an inkling that glyphosate was such an important carcinogen. To me, from our perspective, the blame lies squarely with Monsanto. They manipulated the science, they manipulated the regulation. Everything traces back to there. Unfortunately, as you know, in terms of the scientific proof, can't biopsy most tumors or cancers and find bits of causative agent inside. But in civil courts in America, the burden is generally more likely than not was this chemical a cause of Schiffer's disease, for example. We feel very good about being able to show that for our expert.
Before
we
choose. I have a question. Thank you again for your evidence. I have a question for Mr. Lutzenberg. Putting aside the fact that the U.S. charity system is probably unique in the world, you know that we're here today to consider the culpability, the liability, the responsibility of Monsanto under international law for various harms that are alleged to have been caused to the environment and health. The counterargument might be, well, we don't need to develop international law for that purpose. The U.S. court system is more than capable of dealing with these harms. What would you say to that?
Well, I'd certainly like to see this happening all over the world. I'm delighted to be speaking to the other monolinguist here, Richard Lutzenberg. I'd love to see this on a global scale. I'm not familiar with the civil justice system in other countries, but certainly this is happening no less regularly in other parts of the world than it is in America. And I do think that holding them accountable in terms of international law is certainly important, and to bring the coverage and the eyes and ears of the world to the issue. How that will work out and how it will affect the bottom line, I guess, remains to be seen. It's not something I know.
Thank you.
Oui, je voudrais poser une question, je pense. Je voulais poser une question qui peut s'adresser aux deux témoins. C'est par rapport aux actions qui sont menées contre Monsanto. Je vois que Madame Christine a eu vraiment des déboires considérables par rapport à sa maladie. Elle a eu des dépenses extraordinaires qu'elle a eues à a occasionné en raison des problèmes qui ont été posés par les produits qui ont été vendus par Monsanto. Alors, je voulais savoir s'il y a eu effectivement une plainte qui s'est adressée après avoir reçu ces constats-là, qui s'était vu effectivement au produit, si elle s'est adressée à Monsanto pour effectivement dire voilà les résultats des tests qui ont été faits et qui ont été avérés par les experts et quelle a été la réaction du Monsanto. C'est dans un premier temps, parce que je vois que maintenant, il y a eu effectivement des actions qui sont en cours et qui sont en train d'être menées, mais lorsque le problème s'est passé pour Madame Christine, est-ce qu'il y a eu de la part de Monsanto, elle a été saisie d'abord, et est-ce qu'il y a eu une réaction de sa part?
Thank you very much.